मेरे जो विधायक है उस पर पूरा विश्वास है और नतीजा कल अच्छा ही आया। मेरे जो विधायक है उस पर पूरा विश्वास है और नतीजा कल अच्छा ही आया।
ऑलराइट, बट इन रियलिटी द नंबर्स गेम इज टाइट फॉर अहमद पटेल। लेट्स जस्ट नाउ लुक एट द नंबर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई। नाउ टू विन दैट राज्यसभा सीट इन गुजरात इट रिक्वायर्स 45 MLAs. Whoever hits it is through. The BJP has 121 MLAs in all, but at least 45 votes each will go to Amit Shah, another 45 to Smriti Irani, so 90 in all. That leaves 31 balance for the BJP, which is still 14 MLAs short of the halfway mark. Now the Congress on paper has 51 MLAs, but only 44 went to Bangalore. So the BJP's game is to see if they can limit it to that 44. Now if only 44 vote for Ahmed Patel, the only way he can win is if at least one of the NCP's two MLAs or the JDU's sole MLA votes for him. That will take him over the edge. Now Ahmed Patel claims that the NCP has promised to vote for him.
नो बनानी, आज अभी मुझे मैसेज आया है कि उन्होंने सपोर्ट अनाउंस किया है, तो अपना व्हिप भी जारी करेंगे।
बट वन ऑफ द टू एनसीपी एमएलएज हैज जस्ट दिस इवनिंग सेड दैट प्रफुल्ल पटेल कॉल्ड हिम अप एंड आस्क्ड हिम टू वोट फॉर द बीजेपी।
प्रफुल्ल पटेल से बात हुई है, हाईकमान से बात हुई मेरी, उधर से मुझे आदेश मिला है कल वोटिंग करने का है, तो बीजेपी के उम्मीदवार को सबको वोट देने के लिए बोला गया।
तो दोनों की एक ही राय
है? किसके दोनों की?
बीजेपी में दो लोग हैं तो दो लोग बीजेपी को कर रहे हैं।
हाँ, तो वो ही प्रफुल्ल भाई का आदेश है, तो दोनों की एक ही राय होगी ना, 100%।
ओके, सो द बिग लास्ट मिनट शॉकर देयर फ्रॉम द एनसीपी। नाउ ऑल्सो वर्थ नोटिंग दैट जेडीयू एमएलए हु अहमद पटेल क्लेम्स इज प्रॉमिस्ड टू सपोर्ट हैज गॉन मिसिंग। नाउ सो द बीजेपी एज वी हैव सीन is still 14 votes short of a majority, and so their best case scenario is not an outright win, but to ensure that Ahmed Patel only ends up with that 44 number or even less. In that case, he too falls short of a majority. Now, under the rules, if both sides fall short of a majority, then the election goes into the second preference votes and the BJP will win easily. Let me explain. In a Rajya Sabha election, voters have an option of a second choice. So all BJP MLAs who voted for Amit Shah and Smriti Irani as first choice would give the BJP candidate, the third candidate, as their second choice. That means that Mr. Rajput will get all 121 BJP votes, which will of course be a big majority over the Congress's 44 or whatever the Congress finally ends up with. All right, joining me tonight, the night before the Game of Thrones, Abhishek Manu Singhvi of the Congress is with me, and also live from Ahmedabad, Jayanaran Vyas of the BJP. Abhishek Singhvi, now it's looking extremely fragile for Ahmed Patel with this latest development, which you may have just heard, that the NCP, which so far had promised to support Mr. Patel and even promised to issue a whip, you have an MLA saying that Prafull Patel has asked him to vote for the BJP. Are you worried?
Srinivas, I am not at all worried. Ahmed Patel is a very tall leader, and in Gujarat he is unbeatable, and I have no doubt that he will win. But I want you to step back for just half a minute and sure. Consider. We in the programs now on television are only talking of who will win. Srinivas will win, Singhvi will win, who will win. But are you now not seeing that the arithmetic is clear from the beginning, namely two for BJP and one for Congress? So obviously when for the last 1 week we are talking of these individual things, are we not making a mockery of the anti-defection 10th schedule law? It may not strictly apply to Rajya Sabha elections,
yes.
But are we not making mockery of the principle which we call a constitutional sin? And
okay.
Secondly, tell me, why will a single MLA out of 51 vote for you unless there is inducement? And why will he vote for any BJP unless the inducement comes from
the
BJP?
Let me put that
so what
to
you're
the...
really talking of is, look, we, just give me half a second, half a second. What you're really talking of is, Srinivas, you have all the rules. You have a constitution, you have the law, But ultimately, the winner takes all. Ethics be damned, rules be damned, morality be damned.
Okay, let me...
lectures and seminars, we will sermonize about anti-corruption. Remember...
Let me take that to Jayanarayan Vyas. Because some would argue, Abhishek, that... this is also as much a reflection of the Congress's own faulty mismanagement and ability or inability to hold together a crumbling opposition front. But I'll put that to you in a second. Let me just take 30 seconds more. I'll come back to you on that. I just want to go to Jayanarayan Vyas.
Everybody says this, but let me tell you, Srinivas, how are you, if you are actually bribing me, then to talk of my inability to manage myself, I mean, this is ridiculous. You are really directly, openly, brazenly, in broad daylight, as a ruling party in the center of the state, guilty of bribery. And you are then saying that it's your fault that you can't manage.
Okay, Jayanarayan Vyas.
Obviously, we are managing. But the point is, it exposes you. It exposes you.
Jayanarayan Vyas. Open bribery, open inducement from a party that claims to be taking the higher moral ground on
corruption. You always prefer long arguments. And that's what, as an eminent lawyer, my friend Abhishek Manu Singhvi is indulging in. See, his issue is, I do agree with him that there are laws, anti-defection law is there, and there are so many other things also which apply to these elections. I think unless until there is a violation, and that too can happen only of their own volition.
Yes.
You know, you can't just put the blame on Bharatiya Janata Party. You know, Congress MLAs resign. Where is the question of their brazenly violating the anti-defection law? They are not able to keep their flock together. They are resigning. Still, they are not confident.
So they take them
to Bangalore. They are back now. Still, they are further not more confident.
Let me ask you. Why are they resigning? Can you hear me? I'm asking you why are they resigning? Why is now that NCP MLA saying that the NCP is going with the BJP? Is this all only happening for the love of the BJP that they've suddenly discovered? Are we being naive here?
you know, Srini, you raised, Vasu, a very, very pertinent question. Why are they resigning?
Yes.
You know, this is their house is in, it's a divided house. Shankar Singh Wagela, for far too long, they permitted him a long rope to do whatever he wanted to. They could not succeed convincing him. Ultimately, it is this faction that is walking out of their camp. So where is BJP in picture? I don't understand.
What about the NCP MLA?
You could not manage till last meet, till yesterday.
But what about the NCP? Why would the NCP vote for you? Why would the NCP vote for you? What is that reason?
See, this shows that when, you know, like a sinking ship, even their partners have started losing faith in them. Now, where is BJP responsible for that?
Okay, let me take that to Abhishek.
If NCP wants to cast their vote for BJP, it's a clear-cut sign that it is the last nail in the coffin that is being delivered, because they have lost faith in their partners. That is their internal problem. It is problem between NCP and Congress. Where is BJP?
Let me take that to Abhishek. And Abhishek, just add to that you could make the argument of inducement in the case of what happened in Gujarat, with the MLAs crossing over. But when you look at the wider landscape of this opposition unity or the lack of it, then how would you make that argument? I mean, if you take Nitish, for example, the inducement argument won't apply there. Doesn't that come back to the fact that the Congress, which is meant to be the central pivot for some sort of opposition axis, has simply failed on the job?
Look, let's get a few concepts clear. Srinivas, those MLAs who resign do not win or lose you a Gujarat election. Let's get that clear first. Now, the ones who remain, if you are able to induce them, and the figures we have been hearing consistently, and we know the power of the figures, we have seen it in the brazen naked display of figures in Uttar Pradesh, we have seen it in the naked display of figures elsewhere in the national elections, are between 15 and 10 CR. Well, then, there is nothing to talk about those who have resigned, because resigned people don't vote. The ones who remain vote. Number two, if a NCP MLA gives a statement today Do you really think that Praful Patel would want himself to be quoted that he has telephoned him to resign? Do you really think it's possible? Have you gone and asked Praful Patel? What has talked is a note which has a name called Praful Patel, but the note is big note or some other promise of a ministerial post. You know, by what are you corrupted? You may not be corrupted by money alone, but right. by ambition, by so many other things.
Are you saying
now,
that? Are you
today,
saying that's what may have happened with the NCP?
We are finding what is happening. No, I am saying that it is really being tried. I am not saying it's going to happen tomorrow because I have full confidence in the one man who knows Gujarat like the back of his hand. But right. the point I'm making is that what you are having is a naked justification in front of cameras for 1 week saying,
right.
whatever happens is the number which counts. It's the victory which counts. We will do everything. We'll do Sam, Dam, Dand and Bhed.
Right.
And we'll do most of these four. We'll do Dam. And then we'll do Bhed. So hook or by crook, more by crook, less by hook. Victory
more,
is what
okay.
we want. Now, the,
okay,
the problem,
more,
point
okay,
here
let,
is,
let him respond.
This is
more
politics
by hook?
Of morality. This is politics of sermonizing by the BJP. This
okay,
is the politics
okay.
of... you know,
Jainarayan Vyas, more by crook, less
ethicality.
By hook. Jainarayan Vyas.
No, Vasu, I'd like to correct Abhishek on 2 points. Number one, he said Mr. Ahmed Patel is a very tall leader. Yes, I think I don't challenge him on that statement because it is their assessment. But he says he has never lost an election in Gujarat. This was similar confidence expressed by late Mr. Rajiv Gandhi. He said, agar Gujarat mein 26 seat mein se 25 haar sakte hain,
right.
ye Bharuj ki seat to hum nahi haarenge. And then Mr. Patel got defeated on that seat. So thereafter, he has never faced the electorates.
Yes.
He never fought an election. He has preferred to go through Raj Sabha route.
Right.
So I think this tall leader theory will now end with, it has started with Raj Sabha. First, it didn't work in Lok Sabha. Now it is the end of Raj Sabha route also for Mr. Ahmed Patel. And I think what my friend Abhishek is trying to make out is, I think for tomorrow, this is all a kind of a net practice that he is indulging in, that when tomorrow the results are out, he can explain that this is what we were saying yesterday and this is what has happened. Basically, it is in-house problem of Congress. They don't have
Abhishek,
an acceptable
yes,
leader.
Wants to come in.
They don't
okay, allow,
have
allow him to allow
in
him
Gujarat,
to rebut.
They
Abhishek,
have four
go ahead.
Leaders who amongst them
Abhishek,
they keep fighting. So this is their invite. This is nothing beyond invite of Congress.
Yeah. Go ahead, Abhishek.
Srinivas,
go ahead. Yes.
It's very interesting. It's very interesting, Raj Srinivas. Unlike a Lok Sabha election, first of all, I think he's misquoting me. I never said that he's never lost an election. I never talked about losing or winning. I'm talking about the means being used to win or lose an election.
You said that.
Fight him
you,
fair.
You, Abhishek, you better
don't
go through
this.
Okay, okay, okay,
I never
okay.
mentioned about never lost. I
okay,
said,
Abhishek, go ahead.
Anyway, let me finish now, please. Now, look at this whole inverted logic. Unlike Lok Sabha, where you actually don't know the result because the general electorate on the ground votes for you, in a Rajya Sabha, it's an open vote. It is virtually a vote where I have to mark, unlike even president, vice president, you have to show your vote. And you show your vote to your chief whip if you like. Now, therefore, before the election starts, you know exactly how many seats will be won on the numbers alone,
right.
if the rules are adhered to. So before you start, you know that you cannot win Mr. BJP, a third candidate. Now, just rewind for a minute. Apply logic.
Okay.
Why would the BJP put up Mr. Rajput? You ask me that, let me ask you that question. The numbers are known. Your intention from the beginning, Mr. BJP, whose friend is there.
He's a trusted ally
please
of
answer
Mr.
why you put up Rajput? Because
Mr.
Rajput, let me complete.
Rajput's
one minute. Let me. So Rajput is put up. Rajput is put up as a trusted ally of Ahmed Patel. Rajput is put up as a trusted ally of Ahmed Patel, knowing that the numbers are 31. Number two, it is proof positive that from day one, your whole game plan is to allure, bribe, induce,
they want to,
overpower.
They want a contest.
Three,
maybe that's why they put
MLAs
it up.
MLAs don't realize.
No, maybe they want a contest
oh,
and
I
to
see.
I whether
see.
The,
after you put up a contest with
strength.
A defector, and then on 31 numbers, and thereafter, you do these kind of things every day.
Okay, Jainarayan Vyas, respond to that.
To use
okay, Jainarayan Vyas, respond to
this
that.
Is happening
why
with
do you
party in power?
Why do you want to fight this seat?
Now was it simply just to split the Congress? Accepting that Mr. Ahmed Patel may not have the required numbers, I think in that case the game will go to the second preference votes. And if it is a second preference vote, I think BJP must be absolutely cocksure about the third candidate's win. So I think it is not by any hook or crook. It is by simply arithmetic, that the arithmetic favors BJP because they have larger vote share and second preference votes ultimately. If they are not able to keep their flock
should
Mr. Ahmed Patel not qualify in getting the minimum first preference
vote, I think second preference vote is bound to see
the third candidate getting elected.
Why did you want to contest
this seat? So I think it's arithmetic. It is nothing beyond arithmetic. And I think whoever has planned this arithmetic, he must have applied his mind.
No, but why did you want to contest this seat? Was it simply, as Abhishek alleges, to break the Congress through whatever means possible? Sam, dam, dand, ved. When you didn't have the numbers, why did you try to get into the gate?
Let us understand that they are a terrible house, divided. They went on hobnobbing with Shankar Singh Wagela's faction for far too long. If at all anybody is to be blamed, Congress themselves are to be blamed for the kind of strategies they adopted and their strategy planners. You know, when you have to field a candidate like Mr. Ahmed Patel, they should not have taken risk with these kind of hobnobbing with the their own MLAs. So they permitted Shankar Singh Wagela to go on with their arguments. Ultimately, they fell through.
It is
their failure at the negotiation table. It is their failure at the negotiation table, which is trying to turn on BJP, which is absolutely wrong.
Okay, Abhishek, in hindsight, was this a bit of a disastrous management of somebody like Shankar Singh Wagela? Because remember, and I said this at the outset, that had Mr. Wagela not walked out, Ahmed Patel would possibly have not found himself in the crisis that he is in today.
Look, I have great respect for Mr. Wagela, and I will not go into that history. But let us be clear. What do you want? Do you want us to go and tie Mr. Shankar Singh Wagela's hands and drag him to vote for us? Mr. Ahmed Patel has met him more than once. Mr. Gehlot has met him more than once. There is no disrespect to him. But let us not talk about the second kind of Sam Dam Dand Bhed, and in that case, more of Dand, which is being used against Mr. Wagela for many months now by the central government agencies. We all understand how many arrows Mr. Modi's government has in its armory. And they choose to fire sometimes the arrow of inducement and allurement, the dam, sometimes the dand. And these are pressure tactics brought on. And we understand Mr. Wagela has maintained a very respectable and a very dignified silence till now. He has not claimed that he has joined the BJP. And his silence and his reading between the lines tells you clearly what he has, how he has been browbeaten, forced and pressurized.
Okay.
So let's look at reality.
My point
is that for a party which gives us so many homilies, this is actually a very good thing that this is happening, because it is exposing the BJP day in and day out before the public of India and of Gujarat.
Okay. Well, we'll have to leave it there with both of you. Who it is exposing and whose reality is coming out is something which is going to be a matter of open debate. Jainan and Vyas, we are out of time with both of you. We'll have to leave it there, because we go now to Shankar Singh Wagela. And as Abhishek mentioned, that he has been maintaining a silence until now, but he did give us his first television interview a short while ago in Gandhinagar, an exclusive interview. Because remember, Wagela, with his own vote and perhaps his son vote and his supporters, even if the NCP deserts the Congress and others do, even if he votes and perhaps some of his supporters vote, then Ahmed Patel may be through, but he can also dent the Congress. So he is, in a way, another kingmaker in this election. I spoke to him earlier today and I began by asking him, what is his decision? Is he going to back Ahmed Patel, as he had earlier hinted he will?
See, each and every voter is a total is a owner of his own votes. So Ahmed Bhai, I have good relations. I discussed so many times with Ahmed Patel. So it is our inner matter with me and Ahmed Bhai Patel. Therefore, it is I to decide and Ahmed to decide what to do and what not to do.
So you're saying there's no decision yet, no decision yet by you?
It is my personal thinking, a personal decision. Make up mind is a no way to whom to what, whom not to what. It's not question of the 11th hour I have to make up the mind. No, it's already make up the mind.
Okay, you said you've already made up your mind. You're not telling us what that is though. So in other words, Ahmed Patel is not guaranteed your vote.
See, what is concerned, it is totally a personal property of an MLA. I don't want to expose, especially you. I will expose the
No, you don't want to expose it, but what are your equations with Ahmed Patel? At least tell me that.
I was elected in member Lok Sabha in 77 Janata rule, and Ahmed was elected in for the Congress party. Since 77, we are cordial friends. At that time, I was in Janata Party with BJP. In those days, Ahmed Bhai was in the Congress Party. Though I was going to visit Ahmed Bhai's residence at Baruch Ankleshwar. Even now, today also, our relations are very cordial. Today morning, we discussed on the telephone. Tomorrow also, he's going to ring me. After 8th also, we are going to see each other. No problem. Our relations are without political parties.
Okay, your relationship is without political parties. That could be read in any which way. But let me ask you this, that are you in touch with Congress MLAs though?
I disown political parties, including BJP and Congress. So it's now not my on moral ground, I should not be in touch with Congress party MLAs, and I am not.
Have you had any sort of offer from the BJP though? Because there's even talk that they offered you a governorship.
No, मेरी कोई बीजेपी से ऑफर की बात नहीं हुई है. ऑफर का सवाल ही पैदा नहीं होता है. See, when publicly I said that I have less concern with political parties, means it means something. I have no any personal interest to negotiate with the BJP, that what about me, what about party, what about you? No, sorry.
Okay, I just want to understand one thing though, that, you know, you said that you left the Congress because they were marginalizing you, you were not given enough prominence, it's a house in disorder. But the fact is that you've been in the Congress for many years, since 2002, but even under your watch, the Congress has lost every single assembly election.
देखिए मैं 2002, 2007, 2012 में मैं नया कांग्रेस में आई वाज फ्रॉम द बीजेपी ब्रांडेड मैन. सो कभी हमने प्रेशर नहीं किया था. इस समय पूरी जीतने की संभावना थी, इसलिए मेरा आग्रह था कि भाई जो मैं जानता हूं वो आप कोई नहीं जानते हैं. हर एक की एक सिस्टम होती है, ट्रिक होती है, आर्किटेक्चर होता है, उसको मालूम होता है कि कौन कहां कैसे रखना चाहिए. सब आर्किटेक्चर बनने से वो मकान की डिजाइन सही नहीं होती है.
ओके, लास्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू शंकर सिंह वगेला. यू आर स्टिल रिफ्यूजिंग टू कमिट टू वेदर यू आर गोइंग टू बैक अहमद पटेल और नॉट, बट यू डिड से दैट ही डज कॉल यू एवरी डे, इवन स्पोक टू यू टुडे. बट हैव यू ऑल्सो स्पोकन टू अमित शाह?
नो, आई एम सॉरी, बीजेपी के लोग कोई टच में नहीं है. जरूर कोई पूछते हैं, क्योंकि जो कैंडिडेट बने हैं वो कल कांग्रेस में थे, अहमद भाई के पुराने 35 साल के दोस्त थे, मेरे रिलेटिव तो बाद में बने. और ये जो है इसके बारे में जरूर हमको पूछते हैं कि आपके समधी है, इनको जिताना है, क्या करेंगे क्या नहीं. मैंने बोला नाउ पार्टीज लुक आउट, पार्टी टू डू इट, वॉट एवर आप जो करना है आप करिए, जहां मेरे को ठीक लगता है वहां मैं आपको कहूंगा ऐसा करना चाहिए ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए.
All right, Shankar Singh Vaghela, thanks very much indeed for that. So those cryptic answers giving us a sense of how close this election is going to be tomorrow. That's it on Reality Check. Thanks for watching. Good night.